You're very welcome here to the LYIT Arena in Letterkenny, where we are just tipping in for the last game of the evening and the first final indeed of the weekend. It is the Women's Super League playoff final. It is between Ambassador UCC Glanmire and Courtyard Liffey Celtics. I'm joined here by NUIG Mystics head coach Mike Murray. Mike, what can we expect today from these two teams?
Pretty much all of the same. The biggest difficulty Liffey Celtics are going to have is that they're without their star player, Emma O'Connor. So they're going to have to really step up their game, the rest of these players.
Yeah, of course, Emma getting that injury last week, horrific injury down in Waterford when they played their semi-final against DCU Mercy. But back to this evening, and that is Sork Tiernan putting up the first shot of the game and netting it in style for Courtyard Liffey Celtics, wearing green and playing left to right on your screens there. Lovely three there from Sork Tiernan. And Glanmire tried to respond at the other end and do so in style. Casey Grace getting the two for them. Of course, it's not the first time these two sides have met this year, Mike.
No, they've met before. As a matter of fact, in the league, Liffey gave them a beating in the league in early February, which was a big result for them. But since that, it was only one of the two losses that they had all season for Glanmire. But yeah, they're well capable of putting it up to them. They had them before in the cup as well, as we saw the cup final, and Glanmire came out very strong that day. But yeah, they really have to up their game today if they want to get this Glanmire side.
Yeah, Glanmire, of course, chasing four in a row for this playoff title. They've already scooped four Hula Hoops National Cup titles in a row back in January with, as you said, Mike, that win over Liffey Celtics back in January. They then were crowned regular season champions a couple of weeks ago and are looking to make it three titles this year and four playoff titles in a row if they can this evening. Casey Grace swings it back around to Anya O'Connor. She's called for the travel, though, and it's going to be a Liffey Celtics ball. 8:21 on the clock here in quarter one, the fifth game of the day and the first final of this National League Finals weekend. Three more finals tipping in tomorrow from 12. As Sorka Tiernan comes back up the court, feeds it across to Jasmine Boone. Boone's waiting for her team to make the moves around. Lovely ball inside to Anna Poopin. Poopin, well blocked by Casey Grace, pops it back out to Boone. Doesn't fall for Boone though, but great rebounding in there by Anya O'Connor, Mike.
Yeah, Anya O'Connor can really hit those boards. She's a tall girl. She's well able and physical to get in there and pull down those rebounds. We got to see Jasmine hitting those shots from outside, and she'll continue to take those all evening long as she gets them. But as everybody knows, Glanmire plays a really, really tough defense. This Grainne O'Dwyer away on the fast break, and a strong two.
We could see Grainne doing that all day, really, Mike. She's been showing her worth for many years now on the Women's Super League scene.
Absolutely. And two players following her as well. They really complement each other on the floor. They run the ball fast and they play super tough defense all day long.
Well, Dwyer will go to the free throw now for the bonus. Misses it. And it's
one.
O'Connor again for the rebound as she feeds it to Sorka Tiernan down to Jasmine Boone. Slows things down. Waits for them to set up. O'Connor. Sorka Tiernan's moving around the key for it. She finds her. Into Alva O'Connor, she pops up the shot. Just rolls out, and Anya McKenna on the break now. Manages to keep it in play. Over to Grainne O'Dwyer, outside to Grace. Grace with the dribble, over to McKenna. And it doesn't fall for her as Liffey Celtics' Anna Poopin gives it to O'Connor. O'Connor's shot doesn't drop either. Sorka Tiernan rebounding well in there though.
Yeah, they're getting some second chances on the offensive boards. I didn't expect those, because usually Glanmire are very good at boxing out and keeping them off the board. But offensively, they've gotten three or four offensive rebounds already.
Oh, lovely score there by O'Connor as well. It's nip and tuck here. Casey Grace replies in style at the other end.
That's typical for what Glanmire do, Mary. They get that even, especially after a basket, and they just hit you straight back straight away. They push the ball really quick.
Sorka Tiernan called for the travel there. 6:43 to go in this first quarter. as Anya McKenna over to Alford. Alford with the long three. And it's back with Liffey Celtics. Jasmine Boone is calling for it. She gets it. Misses the layup though. Sorka Tiernan's on hand. Can she finish? She can.
Good put back there by Sorka Tiernan. Good follow.
Six, 10 to go. Anya McKenna setting things up for Mark Scannell's side once more. Chantal Alford inside Grania Dwyer, who snuck in behind Anna Poopin. Didn't fall though, and it's Sorka Tiernan once more taking the point guard mantle inside to Boone.
Chantal's got a real threat of a shot from the outside. It should create a lot of space for some of them in the inside as well, because they just got to get out, and that they can't leave her to shoot those open threes.
Claire Rockall on the ball now for Glanmire. And a foul is called.
On Jasmine Boone.
On Jasmine. Midway through this first quarter, Mike, how do you think the defences are shaping up? You've already said Glanmire play a tough defence. They're known for it indeed, but Liffey Celtics are keeping them at bay.
They're keeping them at bay, but they grind you down usually. And I think depth on their bench, they have a stronger bench, but it's usually around the third or the fourth that you see that depth coming through. Nice two from Gracie Grace.
Just 1 point in it meanwhile at the moment. 5:13 on the clock, and that's just gone out there for a Liffey Celtics ball. Jasmine Boone going to be inbounding this into Tiernan. Good defense there by Anya McKenna. Great at the top there, getting a hand in. Jasmine Boone drives in through herself. Oh, good score from Jasmine.
Yeah, that's a tough two from Jasmine. She plays bigger than she actually is. She's a real physical, tough player, and she can take it strong to the hole.
Definitely, and she's no stranger to pulling down the rebounds either.
Yeah.
Anya McKenna twists, turns, drives. Doesn't go for it, though, and Anya O'Connor has Alva in front of her if she needs her. Goes herself, though.
Liffey Celtics haven't given away this game in any way, you know. I'm sure they'd love to do the business for Emma as well.
Definitely last game of the season, of course, this, with three more finals tomorrow. Men's League Cup final between BFG Neptune and Killorglin, while the Women's Division 1 final, ITC Basketball of Carlow, face Marble City Hawks at 2 o'clock, followed by the Champions Trophy at 4 between Temple Oak and Garvey's Tralee Warriors. But back to here, and it's Anya McKenna. Pops it to Claire Rockall. Rockall drives. Just doesn't get that layup in for her though, and Boone.
She's had a very good last quarter of the season, Claire Rockall. She stood up really well for them towards the second half of the season.
Definitely, she's such a threat there. As Alford fires the ball up the court, but it's gone over the sideline. So it's going to go back to Liffey Celtics. 3:58 to go in this first quarter. And the title, the Women's Super League playoff title, is what we're playing for here. Hugh is going to come out on top.
Looks like Leslie Ann Wilkinson's coming into the game.
The two is good there, and we're going to be heading to the free throw line as well. Indeed, as you said, Mike, Leslie Ann Wilkinson checking into the game for Glanmire in place of Anya McKenna.
That's a good strong move to the baskets from Anna Poopin there. She's been doing that all season for them too. She's been very strong. She's been constant and works really hard.
Yeah, indeed, she was very strong for them against DCU last week as well. She misses that one though, and Grania Dwyer happy to collect that rebound. 3:47 to go here. Liffey Celtics with a 5-point lead. Rockall finds Grace inside. Dwyer takes it on herself, drives around Anna Poopin and to the net. Anna Poopin again driving lovely pass out to Alva O'Connor, who finds Anya. Anya takes it on herself over the head of Casey Grace and into the net.
Anya started really well too. She's taken those strong drives to the basket. She's doing a good job on Chantel as well. It's a nice two from Chantel.
And as you mentioned earlier, Glanmire very good at replying almost immediately.
They come straight back at you. They don't allow you to relax after a score. They hit other teams' weaknesses very well.
Long shot there. Oh, fantastic score from Karen Mealy, who was checked in place of Sorka Tiernan. As yet again, it has come to Chantal Alford to try and grab a score back, but that one didn't fall for it this time, and it's O'Connor up to Boone. Boone drives herself, gets her own rebound, surrounded by three, and somehow gets it back out to Mealy. Mealy's shot is rebounded by Boone. And they are eight up with 2:04 to go here in quarter one. Grace at the other end. She makes it look easy, Mike.
Yeah, those shots, they're uncontested shots. They're nice shots to get to bring your confidence back in, especially at the earlier on in the game.
O'Connor to Boone, across to Mealy. Out to O'Connor. Poopin was calling for it, got it, and a lovely drive to the basket again by Poopin.
Lovely reverse move, yeah, really nice.
1:29 on the clock as Grainne Dwyer at the other end gives it off to Rockall, fires it out to Wilkinson. A lovely drive from Wilkinson. As we are heading for a timeout with 1:21 on the clock. Welcome back here to the Women's Super League playoff final between Ambassador UCC Glanmire and Courtyard Liffey Celtics. Liffey Celtics holding a 16-22 point lead at the moment with 1:19 on the clock here in quarter one as Chantel Alford inbounds the ball to Dwyer.
I think we're going to see some intensity on the defense straight away. They're going to press up from now on, I think. Coach Scannell has told him he wants him to push up on the ball. Got a turnover straight away from it too.
Good hands there from Karen Mealy, but only pops it out as far as Chantel Alford, who finds Grace inside. Lovely sidestep. Good rebounding there by Rockall, and she draws the foul under the basket as well. Subs in for Glanmire. Hannah McCarthy checking into the game for the first time. She's coming in for Grainne Dwyer. Just giving Grainne a rest there with 55 seconds to go here in quarter one as Rockall on the free throw line. First one's good. Two from
and
two.
The second one good too.
She's such an impressive player, Rockall.
She really is, yeah. Yeah, this intensity, this press is paying off. That's two turnovers straight away. That's what they do to you.
Casey Grace, again, nice sidestep in. Doesn't fall for it, and Chloe Mullins battling hard. That's there for Liffey Celtics, yeah. Mullins to Mealy, to Poopin, O'Connor, out to Boone. Boone takes on the shot, and O'Connor, great rebounding.
Tough rebounds. She's hitting them offensive boards, and she had Claire Rockall working really hard on her as well. It's an impressive rebound.
17 seconds to go here in quarter one. What a great
pass.
Vision from Chantel Alford inside to Rockall.
Just 8 seconds left here. Jasmine's got that. I'd say she's going to look for this last shot.
3-2. Is she going to take it off?
That's the three.
She is. And it's
short.
Just short. End of quarter one. Glanmire 20. Courtyard Liffey Celtics 24. Welcome back here to the Women's Super League playoff final in LYIT Letterkenny, where it is Ambassador UCC Glanmire against Courtyard Liffey Celtics once more in a final this year. Liffey Celtics leading the way by 4 at the moment. Mike, how do you see things went after the first quarter?
Liffey Celtics have to be happy with the way they've played. They've been offensively very tough, and defensively they've been really good, but Glanmire are going to start that press and they're going to start pushing the ball. I think they're going to press up even higher. They caused two turnovers earlier or late on in that first quarter, and they'll be looking to replicate that later on, I'd say.
Louise Scannell on the court there for Glanmire. Gives it off to Rockall. Rockall back out to Wilkinson. Back into Rockall. Good defense there from Liffey Celtics.
Without a doubt, they're really stepping up.
Out to Tiernan for the long shot. We've seen her hit many of them this year. She's gone out there for a Liffey Celtics ball. Just popped off Louise Scannell there by the looks of it.
Shocking thing about that there. There were three Liffey Celtics players and no Glanmire player in there for that rebound, which is, you know, it's not like what they do, because they're usually, on their own boards especially, extremely tough. But Liffey Celtics are really bringing it to them.
Rania Dwyer and Anya McKenna checking back into the game, just as you were speaking there, Mike, with Casey Grace and Leslie Ann Wilkinson heading for a rest. Sorka Tiernan for Liffey Celtics across to O'Connor.
3 seconds on the clock, two, and a turnover.
A foul by the looks of it.
That bailed Anya out there.
And it's going to be a Liffey Celtics ball.
Yes, foul on Anya McKenna.
Jasmine Boone across to Mullins, to Tiernan, back to Boone. Lovely inside to O'Connor. She wasn't expecting it, but took it on. Oh, Boone.
Big three from Boone. I was wondering how long they'd leave Chantel off. They need to get their starters back in. They're 9 points down. This is sort of a bit of unknown territory for Glanmire.
And Grania Dwyer tried to grab one back there as Jasmine Boone skips around her. And it's going to be a foul against Louise Scannell of Glanmire there as Chantel checks back into the game. As to does Anna Poopin for Liffey Celtics, with Claire Rockall and Anya O'Connor making way.
It's early on yet, you know, it's just second quarter, 8 minutes into this, 8 minutes left in the second quarter, but I have to say that Celtics are doing really, really well. Bit of complacency possibly from Glanmire, but
Poopin did extremely well there and is after getting her own rebound there as well. Tiernan called for the travel. You always get the sense that Poopin's going to do something, Mike, every time she comes on.
Yeah.
It's just she seems to have the right spark about
her. She's very much
about
a utility player. She does a lot. She can drive strong to the hole. She's very tough defensively. I'd love to see the amount of offensive rebounds. Liffey Celtics must have, I'd say they're up on 9 or 10 offensive rebounds at this stage.
Oh, good score there from Chantel. Yeah. 7:30 to go here, and it's a 7-point game. As Liffey Celtics, Chloe Mullins over to O'Connor to Sorka Tiernan. Back outside to Mullins, to Poopin.
Nice move from Poopin. Nice ball fake. Yeah, they're up on 11 offensive rebounds at this stage. That's really good offensively. They're getting their second chances and they're making them count too.
Oh, Louise Scannell, a great ball into Grania Dwyer. Just has to find a little bit more space to find the basket. She does so though. And 24-31 is what the scoreboard reads here. Sorka Tiernan to Alva O'Connor. Poopin watching Jasmine Boone intently, finds her. Just unlucky there not to keep control of it. It's Grania Dwyer comes up, has Scannell on her left. She just can't keep a hand to that one though, a bit too much pace on it for her. And it's gone out for a Liffey Celtics ball. Press up on Sorka Tiernan by Anya McKenna. Tiernan's taking it in her stride though. Sends it over to Boone. Chantel Alford gets a hand to it there. Alva O'Connor to Poopin. Tiernan. Mullins is on her left.
Shot clock on 4. Great shot from Sorka Tiernan.
Six oh two to go.
It's a walk. It's a walk on Grania Dwyer.
And it looks like we're heading for a timeout. We are indeed. 6:01 to go here in quarter two. 24-33 in favour of Courtyard Liffey Celtics. Six oh one on the clock here in quarter two in this women's Super League playoff final. between Ambassador UCC Glanmire and Courtyard Liffey Celtics. Celtics with the lead at the moment, 24-33. Mike, if you were in Mark Scannell's shoes at the moment, would you be anything you'd be changing?
No, I just think it's complacency on their behalf. They're just, I think they, you know, with them out and everything, I think there was just a bit of complacency in what they were doing. But I have to say, Liffey Celtics have been up for it from the very beginning. We have Jasmine getting a break on the bench there now as well.
Yeah, and Karen Mealy coming in there for Chloe Mullins as well. As Anya McKenna sets things up once more.
We said in the break, Mary, that, you know, Glanmire, they barely run a fast break, and they love that fast-breaking game. You know, and I think it is a matter of time before they do, but, you know, it's hard with the season they've had not to have a bit of that complacency step in, but it's a long game. A lot of time left yet.
Well, the danger woman, Grania Dwyer, seems to be getting in under that basket a bit easily there. She's after drawing the foul as well, and she's going to go.
That's her straight trademark spin move on the baseline, and she pins the defender.
5:21 to go in this quarter. Dwyer going for the second. Just rims out there, and Liffey Celtics with Karen Mealy manages to hold on to it. Anna Poopin takes it on, pops it out to Tiernan. Oh, lovely score from Tiernan.
She's shooting the ball really well. Nice soft release on that.
Good hands there from Alva O'Connor, but Casey Grace manages to keep it in play for Glanmire. Dwyer. Foul called there.
Off the ball foul.
It's going to be a Glanmire ball from the baseline. .4:54 to go. Alva O'Connor intercepts that pass from Anya McKenna in though. And Karen Mealy for Courtyard Liffey Celtics. Into Poopin. Across to Tiernan. O'Connor. Outside again to Mealy. Anya O'Connor driving through 4 seconds. And it just came off a Glanmire player there. From the looks of it, the ref is giving it to Liffey Celtics.
I think Mark is happy with that call. He may have a point.
Liffey Celtics ball it is though, and Grania Dwyer steals it, but it's come back again. Anna Poopin slows things down. She's got a full shot clock ahead of her. Sirk Tiernan looking for options. Mealy back to Tiernan, goes for that long shot.
She's very composed up at the point, I have to say.
And that ball's just gone out over the sideline as Jasmine Boone comes in for Anna Poopin for Liffey Celtics.
He's going to need to get Jasmine breathers like that every now and again, because she's going to play a lot of minutes here today.
4:05 to go in this quarter. It's a 10-point game. Pace has slowed down a little bit, you might say, Mike. Oh, she's Jasmine. Just off the bench. And straight for a three.
She's got that very high elevation on that shot, but it's very successful.
Alfred at the other end tries to respond in kind, and Rockall thought it came off Rockall herself there, but it's gone out for a Glanmire ball.
Yeah, that looked as if it went off the leg of a Glanmire player, but ref knows better.
And Grania Dwyer called for a travel there as she moves to the basket. And
Grania just keeps going all day. She has some engine on her. She just runs all day long. She's tough.
Yeah, definitely a tough one to come up against, I'm sure.
Liffey Celtics have to be extremely happy at this stage the way they're doing. 3 minutes left in the second quarter. And up by 13 points.
Yeah, solid display so far from them. With Tiernan working her way out of trouble and goes for the shot. A lovely score again from Tiernan. She's on fire today.
She's on fire, but they're uncontested shots. You know, they're just leaving her there. She's taken three or four of those shots from close in, and they're not contesting them at all. You know?
McKenna went up with the shot. Anya O'Connor for the rebound there, but it just couldn't keep it in play. And we are headed for a timeout with 3:02 to go in quarter two. 25-40 in favor of Liffey Celtics. Three-oh-two to go here in quarter two. Courtyard Liffey Celtics in the lead, 25-40 against Ambassador UCC Glanmire. Just as I say it, Casey Grace bags one for Glanmire, or two rather.
Yeah. Back to the full court press again.
2:44 to go. Sirk Tiernan drives in around past Anya McKenna. Just misjudges that one though. McKenna picks it up to Alford. Alford across to McKenna for the long shot. And Jasmine Boone does well to get out of there and drives herself at the other end. Loose ball collected there by Mealy. Out to Alva O'Connor.
Three Celtics players in on top of that rebound that time. They're hitting the boards offensively so strong.
And it's paid off for them, as they've managed to work it back in through Jasmine Boone to make it 27-42 with 1:57 to go here in this second quarter. Grainne Dwyer with the shot. Boone there, ready to rebound.
1:48 left in the second.
You'd have to say Coach Byrne is the happier of the two marks down there.
Absolutely, he's going to be extremely happy right now. And he's still pushing them forward. He's making sure that they're not resting.
He's played Glanmire before. He knows what they're capable of.
Absolutely.
As a Dwyer.
They're not champs for the last 4 years for no reason.
Indeed. Karen Mealy to Anya O'Connor. Finds movement in Jasmine Boone. Boone.
A nice step back. Good luck.
Dwyer at pace gets dispossessed by Sorka Tiernan. Anya O'Connor comes out with it. Has Alva inside. She sees her. And a good layup there.
Tamara just seemed tired. Like Grainne was away on the fast break that time and she didn't have any help. We'd go clear.
There you go.
Like
classic Glanmire there. Lovely ball in to Rockall on the move there. Dwyer just waiting for her before delivering the pass. Boone.
30 seconds left here.
To Tiernan. To Mealy. To Alva O'Connor. Tried to sneak it in to Sorka Tiernan. Anya O'Connor has managed to win it back to Tiernan.
Three in the shot clock. Tough shot. They've still got 13 on the clock though. Plenty of time.
As Grainne Dwyer this time driving inside.
That's a tough basket.
And And that is the end of the first quarter, or the second quarter rather, here in the Women's Super League final. It's 33-44 in favour of Courtyard Liffey Celtics. Welcome back here to Letterkenny and the Women's Super League playoff final between Ambassador UCC Glanmire, chasing four titles in a row, and Courtyard Liffey Celtics, who've been having a pretty good season, Mike, you'd have to say, being in this final here. They've got to a cup final as well, and they finished runners-up in the regular season as well. That's, Mark Byrne's got to be happy with that, never mind the score here, but in general, overall.
Yeah, he has to be happy with the season. We played them twice. They're actually a very big team as well, but physically they work really hard defensively, as they're doing today. They're really taking the game to Glanmire today. We just looked at the stats there at halftime, and we're seeing that Glanmire is 0-for-4 from three. They haven't hit any threes for the whole game, which is very unusual for Glanmire.
Indeed, while at the other end, Sir Kiernan, who has been shooting extremely well for Liffey Celtics today, it has to be said. Nets another one there. And speaking of good scoring, Jasmine Boone, up until the break, was the top scorer for Liffey Celtics with 14 points in the first half. Whereas over on the other end, it is Grania Dwyer who is the top scorer. She's just added another two there, so that's going to bring her tally to 13 for this game so far. And she's just done some nice defense there on Jasmine Boone.
Great defensive work from her.
And Anna Poopin has won it back.
She's not a very tall player, but she posts up really strong, Grania. When she gets inside, she's very, because she's got great footwork, and she gets you on her back, she takes it strong to the hole. Stepped on the baseline.
Yeah, going out for Liffey Celtics ball. 8:31 to go here in this game, in the third quarter. And Anya McKenna was pressing up high there on Tiernan. She's met her again now at the halfway line. Tiernan feeds it across to O'Connor. O'Connor looking for movement, finds it in the form of Alva. Alva takes the dribble, and Chantel Alford.
Fouls. Nice pass in from Anya to Alva there. She had an opportunity to take it up, but she didn't. And then fouls.
Yeah, definitely. We've seen some lovely, lovely passages of play here at both sides of the court. As Rockall. Great steal by Anna Poopin. Somehow manages to keep control of it as well. And goes for the layup.
She was slightly worried there. It looked as if it was going to come out.
7:51 to go in this third quarter as Chantel Alford goes for the long three. Doesn't drop for her, Mike.
Yeah, there's still no threes going down for them. It's the travel.
A lovely pass, though, from Boone to find Anya O'Connor there in space.
Yeah, Anya's really running the floor very well. You know, she's getting up and down, she's getting defensive rebounds, and she's getting up and down the floor very well. Don't think Mark is too happy with the way his team is going. I'd say he had strong words to them at halftime.
Mark Scannell, that is it?
Yeah, sorry, Mark Scannell.
The battle of the marks here?
Yeah, battle of the marks.
And Sorka Tiernan finds Boone. She's Alva O'Connor ahead of her. And takes the shot instead. Falls to Grania Dwyer, who comes back at them at pace and drives straight at the basket. There's two Liffey Celtics players there, and Jasmine Boone comes out with it.
Yeah, Anya O'Connor stood strong on that drive there from Grania Dwyer.
Poopin to Boone. Boone drives through. Tough basket to make, and it doesn't drop for her. As Rockall gives it to Grace, she's Anya McKenna on side. That ball just had a bit too much on it. It's gone out. And we're going for a timeout. Mark Scannell's just called for one there. 6:40 on the clock here in quarter three. Just checking back in after that timeout here in quarter three. 6:37 is what's on the clock here as Jasmine Boone of Courtyard Liffey Celtics sets things up. They're currently holding a 13-point lead over Ambassador UCC Glanmire as Circa Tiernan comes under pressure.
It's a long three from O'Connor.
Bronny Dwyer battles for the rebound and gets the foul as well.
Gets out of O'Connor.
And we're just going over to the sideline.
That's three fouls on Alva O'Connor. And she's going to leave the game.
Just come back again there.
Anya O'Connor's doing a good job on Chantel because she's tall. Big long arms in her, and she's stopping her releasing that shot. Chantel is usually a real sweet three-point shooter, but she hasn't really got any off this game.
Yeah, as Anna Pupin tried to work the ball through to Circa Tiernan there, just didn't go for it all, and we're back with Glanmire. Out to Alford again for that long three. It's just popping off the front there.
Absolutely, but Anya O'Connor was in her face all the time. Nice pass and travel.
You could see the idea she was going for there as we are headed for another timeout. 5:32 to go here in quarter three. It's 35-48 in favour of Liffey Celtics. Welcome back here to Letterkenny, where the Women's Super League playoff final between Ambassador UCC Glanmire and Courtyard Liffey Celtics is in middle of the third quarter, with Chantel Alford going for the three-pointer and Anna Pupin getting a fantastic rebound in there and draws the foul as well, so it's going to be a Liffey Celtics ball.
Yeah, she boxed out really well on that. She got Grania on her back and was able to pull that rebound down.
Interesting the way Glanmire are working here. Mike, they're pressing up.
Yeah, they've been doing it, but in fairness to Liffey Celtics, they've been able to break that press all the time. Sorka's doing a really good job. And then they get Jasmine coming high as well, so.
Sorka to O'Connor. Good hands there.
It's off to Rockall, it's a green ball. Celtics ball.
Glanmire with their starting five on the court. And it's Sorka Tiernan inbounding for Liffey Celtics. She finds Jasmine Boone.
It's short.
It's a very high shot, Mike.
Yeah, she has. She's a very high arc in that shot.
Rockall to McKenna. It's a while since we've had a score here as well.
That's three.
Dwyer just doesn't go for
it. It's a foul on Bronya again.
And it's a Liffey Celtics ball.
There's one thing there. Grania went in for the rebound. She took that shot. She went in for that rebound, but she was the only Glanmire player in contesting that offensive board. We had four
Liffey Celtics players. They're going to have to get tougher on those offensive boards and put pressure on Liffey Celtics.
A nice young player after checking into the game there for Glanmire. While you were speaking there, Mike, Annalise Murphy.
Good second call. That's what Coach Scannell wants. That's what he wants. That's what that press is to do, to just take pressure off them and force their offense to make mistakes.
And it's paid off for them, as you said. Chantal Alford, 4:25 to go, finds Dwyer. Dwyer somehow manages
Boone
to get a shot off.
To the hole.
Boone gets her own rebound. O'Connor is there.
That's
to
O'Connor as well.
To get it. And they're battling hard. And Alford gets it out to Grace, to Dwyer. Stolen by Chloe Mullins. Sorka Tiernan slows things down. To Mullins. Anna Poopen calls for it, gets it. Boone tries to get it inside to Mullins. But Grania Dwyer read that all the way.
Yeah, Grania got back on defense well there.
Claire Rockall driving hard to the basket, gets her own rebound. And the foul is called on that second shot up there. As Mark Scannell introduces Hannah McCarthy back into the game, giving Grania a break with 3:35 to go. Still at 35-48.
Yeah, we didn't think we were going to be here at this stage. Glanmire still trailing by 13 points. And Liffey Celtics looking good. Liffey Celtics are looking good for it. They're really taking the game to them. Very confident in the way that they're playing, offensively moving the ball, setting good picks. Doing a really good job.
Claire Rockall finally breaks that deadlock. It's scoring deadlock with first one from the free throw line. She makes the second
makes
as well.
Second too. You see this press straight back up again.
We're back to 11 points here, 3:34 on the clock as Jasmine Boone gets it across the halfway line safely. Feeds it over to Karen Mealy, who came back in there for Sorka Tiernan in the last couple of seconds. Mullins at the other side. Finds Anna Poopen. Poopen back out to Mullins. If three on the shot clock. And good defense from Glanmire. Ball is turned over and Chantal Alford to Grace. McCarthy screaming for it. She gets it.
Travel.
3:04 to go in this third quarter.
I think they'll be looking to get the ball into Jasmine's hands because she's got good control. She'll get that ball and she'll get that press and get up to three quarters and they can just set their offense.
She's being guarded quite closely though by Chantal Alford as Mealy tries to spin around Annalise Murphy. Anya O'Connor to Poopen. Poopen drives and draws the foul.
Tough move from Poopen. She has been doing that all season for them though. Offensively, she has a good strong drive to the basket. And defensively, she's very tough as well.
Yeah, she's definitely shown no fear here today anyway. This is the first one though. 2:45 to go. Gets the second.
Still keeping that 10-12 point barrier all the time.
Rockall pops it back out to Alford.
That's a three coming.
McCarthy drives through. Oh,
that's
great defense from Poopen. Yeah.
Great check. Jasmine needs to stay now and control this ball.
Boone driving out to Mealy, to Poopen. 6 seconds on the shot clock. Mullins with the long shot. And Boone is there to rebound.
Tough offensive boards. She just missed the putback, but that was a really tough offensive rebound.
Annalise Murphy takes on the three. Doesn't come, just comes off the front of the net. Front of the rim, rather.
You didn't think at this stage, coming towards the end of the third, that we'd be saying that Glanmire are zero for
for three-pointers. No three-pointers on the floor.
Indeed, particularly with Chantal Alford. Normally such a reliable shot. Anya O'Connor to Mullins. Boone. Whatever about the three-pointers.
They're working hard, yeah.
Their defense.
Glanmire working hard.
Alva O'Connor in for Poopin.
Shot clock violation there for Liffey Celtics. We've got 1:33 left in the third.
And over the last couple of months, Mike, even speaking to Mark Scannell after every game they've won or cup that they've lifted, he's always put it down to defense.
Oh yeah, he's very much a defensively minded coach. But they run the ball, and they're used to running. They're used to running and pushing the ball all the time. Yet this evening, we could count on one hand the amount of fast breaks that they've had. And you have to say that a lot of that goes down to Celtics, the work that they're putting in, and defensively they're getting back all the time, so they're shutting down that fast break. I'm sure there's possibly something coach knew that they were going to try and be doing.
Alva O'Connor goes up with the left hand there for that shot with 57 seconds on the clock here in quarter three. Liffey Celtics 12 to the good over Cork's ambassador UCC Glanmire. Chantal Alford. Annalise
Murphy.
You
have to say that Glanmire, they do have character, you know. They've been down games before. They've had a few losses during the season, but they've also been down games where they brought it back. And you can be guaranteed that they won't give up till the last minute, so.
Indeed, they've such leaders on the court, though, as well.
Absolutely.
You know, Claire Rockall, even just there, Anya McKenna, Grania Dwyer, we've seen so many this year.
Claire won't give up till the last second, till that final buzzer goes, Claire will be running, and that's for sure.
23 seconds. Anya O'Connor drives through for Liffey Celtics. Chantal Alford plucks that out of the air. Gives it to Rockall, to McCarthy, to Murphy. There we go.
I think that's the first one that we've seen. Is it, Mary? I think that's the first fast break that we've seen that Celtics haven't got back. We could be seeing a bit of fatigue coming in there too, because they are working very hard.
Indeed, it's back to an 8-point game now. 7 seconds to go in this quarter. I'm sure both teams will be relieved to hear that buzzer. It's been a cracking, tough, hard work as Anya O'Connor drives up, and it's end of quarter three here, 41-49 in favour of Courtyard Liffey Celtics. Welcome back here to Letterkenny and quarter four of this Women's Super League playoff final between Ambassador UCC Glanmire of County Cork and Courtyard Liffey Celtics County Kildare, who are currently holding. I just had to take a pause there, Mike, before I continue. They're now in a 10-point lead.
That's Jasmine for two there. Tough offensive rebound over Chantel Halford, and she get the put back. Another defensive rebound. She's working very hard here today.
Indeed. Just to note, though, from the move between the quarters, Mike, Liffey Celtics held to 5 points in that last quarter. Glanmire only bagging eight, indeed, themselves. You have to say the defense were on top really in the third.
Absolutely. Defensively, that was a really tough quarter for both teams. With the press that Glanmire are putting on, they're putting pressure on the ball all the time. There's Claire Rockall taking strong to the hole.
Good stand by Anna Poopin as well, and it's going to be a travel called.
Just looking at the stats again, they're 0 for 9. Glanmire 0 for 9 from three, which is very, very unusual for
from
them.
The 3-point line.
From the 3-point line.
Jasmine Boone to Alva O'Connor to Karen Mealy. Anna Poopin has been very strong for them today as well.
Absolutely, and there she goes strong to the hole again. That's a serious move, and taking the ball, and Casey Grace is guarding her too.
Alford to Grace. Poopin nearly got it away. Annalise Murphy.
And there we go.
One of the up-and-coming underage stars. And it's back to 9 points. Karen Mealy takes the dribble, spins again, and gets her own rebound while she's at it. Alva O'Connor pops it out to Chloe Mullins. Back to O'Connor. Poopin. O'Connor driving through, just pops off the feet of Casey Grace, who manages to keep hold of it. And Alford picks up the loose ball, gives it back to Grace.
That looked like a walk.
Jasmine Boone manages to keep a hand on that indeed, as play moves quickly back down the other side of the court. 7:35 is what's left in
that's
this
smart
women's playoff final.
Sorry, Mary, that's smart for Jasmine there. She kept held that up. They got to take as much time as they can out of the clock. Each offense is going to mean a lot to them.
She broke the sideline there.
I think Coach Scannell wasn't happy with that call from the referee.
As subs coming in on both sides of the court, Grania Dwyer coming back into the game, while Anya O'Connor and Sorka Tiernan are coming in for Liffey Celtics. Jasmine and Chloe Mullins taking a break there, with Hannah McCarthy going to the bench for Glanmire.
Yeah, I think that's a good substitution. Give them a breather, get them back in. I don't think Jasmine will be staying too long on the bench right now.
It's a long way to that final buzzer though, Mike.
Absolutely.
7:20 to go. A lifetime in basketball. As Karen Mealy out to Anya O'Connor. Anya takes on Chantal Alford. And Anna Poopin. Brilliant rebounding in there again.
Absolutely, with three Celtics players hitting that offensive boards. Only two Glanmire girls in there on the boards.
Oh, Sorka Tiernan.
That's a big three from
Sorka Tiernan. Massive three, yeah.
She's playing really well here today.
Yeah.
She's very composed on the ball when she's bringing it down. And she's hitting those big shots.
Poopin deemed to foul Grania Dwyer on the way to the basket there. So we'll be heading to the free throw line.
And she's going to make her earn her points at the line. She's still giving them nothing easy though.
No, and it's 12 points is still the margin. Grania hoping to reduce that though, as the first one is good for her. Second one drops as well.
Louise Scannell coming into the game. Chantel Alford taking a break. Hasn't really happened for her with her shot today at all.
Foul call there. Poopin misses the first. And the second one is good. Every time Glanmire seems to chip into that lead, Mike, Liffey Celtics respond.
Yeah, you have to say that they're keeping it at that 10 points, that psychological 10 point barrier. And there she is for her two.
Sarah Katerden, she's so confident.
Absolutely.
On the ball. Fantastic to see.
Poopin's going to need to be careful now.
Yeah, I was just thinking that.
Because they definitely need her on the floor because she's working really hard on Grainne Dwyer.
And that is going to be her fourth, is it?
I think they've switched.
Yeah, her fourth. Murphy with the long three. Grainne Dwyer wins it back though.
And she was fouled. That's typical of Grania's desire. She gets in there, she fights every one of those balls.
Pays off for her as well.
Absolutely.
6:15 is what's on the clock here in LYIT Letterkenny. Louise Scannell from outside the three-pointer. Poopin rebounds well and brings it up the court till she finds Sorka Tiernan, who's being guarded by Louise Scannell as Anya O'Connor tests out Claire Rockall's skills. Tiernan again.
That's a really nice move. Lovely crossover. Confident enough to step a little step back. She gets the nice 2 points. I know it's very early with only 5 minutes left, but with the amount of scoring that's been done, they've still got that 13-point lead. It's going to take a lot of work for Glanmire to get back into this game, considering what the score has been like for the last quarter.
Indeed. Anya O'Connor linking with Mealy, and then Anna Poopin finishes off the move, but doesn't get the score, the reward.
In fairness to her, she's blowing pretty hard now.
Grainne Dwyer.
Grainne Dwyer.
So reliable there.
Rebound.
Yeah.
Offensive boards and the putback.
And 4:59 is what's left here as Anya O'Connor gets it over the halfway line. Finds Tiernan. Tiernan to Mealy. To Alva O'Connor. Tiernan again.
Shot clock
is ticking. Tiernan puts the shot up.
Shot clock violation. Didn't hit the ring.
Scannell. To Murphy. Just has a little bit too much on it there. As Jasmine Boone checks back in for Liffey Celtics, as too does Chantelle Alford and Anya McKenna for Glanmire, with the two young stars, Annalise Murphy and Louise Scannell, heading for the bench there for the Cork team. Jasmine straight on the court and causing difficulties already, Mike.
Yeah, they gotta get the ball in her hands every offense from now on, just to control it, bring it up. Get the ball to the three quarters and just run their offenses and take time off the clock. The clock is in their favor, so they gotta take as much out of that clock as they possibly can.
Jasmine again, the target for that inbound, but it doesn't go for it. It's Grainne Dwyer at the other end. Pops it out to McKenna, to Rockall. Rockall inside. Alva O'Connor keeps it away from Dwyer. And it comes up here to Sorka Tiernan, who again keeps a cool head. Sets
Absolutely.
Things up. 3:59 to go in quarter four as Anya O'Connor tries a difficult shot there. Casey Grace, meanwhile, at the other end, does what she does best.
That's what they don't need to do now. They don't need to start running and gunning with Glanmire, because Glanmire just love that game. And they will make you pay if you do that. So they just got to keep the way they've been running their offenses, keep setting those picks, and get the ball into those people that you need the ball, like Jasmine. That's good.
Tiernan for the long shot. Good rebounding there. Pops out to Anya McKenna, to Dwyer. Draws the foul.
There's plenty of time. Plenty of time left for Glanmire. There's 3:18 left.
And we are headed for a timeout. To go here in quarter four, and it's just 9 points, and there we go, Chantal Alford.
That's what they're looking for. That's Chantal's game.
And what a time to bring it.
They're going to press up, so we're down to six.
Anya O'Connor. She's slowing things down.
Seven on the shot clock.
Pooping again.
For two.
It's come to Grainne Dwyer. And she's going all the way. Oh, just rolls out in her though. Sorka Tiernan responds in kind, brings it up at pace. Alva O'Connor.
Glanmire got to push up on that ball now. They got to get right up.
Tiernan to Pooping. Three on the shot clock. She gets it up.
Indecision here. Referees, I think it's a blue ball.
The shot clock violation coming before the out of bounds, did you say?
I don't think so. I think. Shot clock was running. They'll probably have to add on approximately 7 or 8 seconds.
Onto the game clock, yeah.
Yeah, the game clock was continuously running.
So we're just having a bit of discussion here around the table. Till the referees decide what's going to happen. And we've added, as you notice, Mike, we've added some time back onto the game
we're
clock.
We're at 2:03 and it's a blue ball. I think that's a correct call. Well done, referees. I think you'll see Chantel receiving a few picks to come up and look and see if she can get that three off. There it is.
There it is, just as you say it. She just needs to get two of them.
That's tough defense.
And it's a different game. Jeez. Boone draws the foul. Clever drive there, really, by Boone.
Really tough move. There was Sorka O'Connor in the corner that got double teamed. She did really well to get that pass away. She's been very controlled and a really good game this evening.
1:45 is what we're now at on the clock. As Jasmine Boone adds to her side's tally. Chantal Alford to Rockall. Finds Dwyer, but just pops out of bounds.
Turnover Glanmire. Liffey Celtics ball.
And again, that press is there. And goes in to Jasmine Boone.
I don't understand how they need to press up on that ball.
The foul is called there as well. It's going to be a Liffey Celtics ball. 1:27 to go here, Mike. It's not over yet, though.
Bit of an upset on the cards.
They are both heading for team fouls, however, and we have seen many's the game come down to the battle of the free throw line.
Absolutely.
Alva O'Connor. Jasmine Boone does
tough
superbly. Yeah.
Turnover from Anya O'Connor.
Grania Dwyer gets it up the court. McKenna Dwyer takes the long shot. Just kind of comes dead off the backboard there.
Yeah.
58 seconds is where we're at. And it is Jasmine Boone. O'Connor, 41 seconds. Seconds on the clock here, and we're headed for the free throw line. Just as I mentioned there, we are Liffey Celtics now in team foul trouble, and Chantal Alford. Oh, your stomach just drops,
yeah,
Mike, as a
absolutely.
Player when you see that happening.
Yeah. We're going to see Glanmire push strong up on this inbounds. If she makes it, they're going to be up strong. We got a timeout.
We're
coming.
Headed for a timeout indeed. 36 seconds on the clock. Thirty-five point six now, till we find out who is going to be the Women's Super League playoff champions of 2017.
Sorka Tiernan to the line for two. Celtics are in the bonus. Both teams are in the bonus.
She gets it.
It's the first.
Much to the relief of the supporters here.
Absolutely.
And she gets the second, so composed, as we keep saying, and we are going for a timeout once more. 35 seconds to go here, 54-61. 35 seconds to go here in. Sorka Tiernan. O'Connor to Boone. 15 seconds. And a foul is called. Mike, I don't like to say it, but are Liffey Celtics daring to dream at the moment?
Yeah, I think so. With the game that Sorka Tiernan has had, I can hopefully she'll make these two. Yeah. That's very good. There's one happy girl, Emma O'Connor, on the bench down there. I'm sure she'd love to have been out here today.
Indeed, and that's 10. It's all over here in LYIT. Liffey Celtics have done it. They have won 54-64 against Ambassador UCC Glanmire, and they are.
Yeah, they've done an absolutely brilliant job here today. I have to say they've worked so hard.
See.
Just having a bit of a technical difficulty here with their microphones. Super job there from Liffey Celtics. They've done an unbelievable job here today. I'm sure Glanmire will be very disappointed. But you have to say that Liffey Celtics came for it and they really wanted it and worked really, really, really hard. Very much unexpected, but it's great to see Liffey Celtics achieving what they looked for today. And here's the Glanmire team coming up to receive their medals.
Yeah, the presentation's just getting underway here. Teresa Walsh, President of Basketball Ireland, along with Matt Hall, presenting the medals for Ambassador UCC Glanmire, runners-up of this Women's Super League playoff final.
It's going to Dwyer. As per usual, great game from Gronje. I'm sure Coach Scandal will be disappointed, but he's had a great season. Just talking earlier about Emma O'Connor and how she blew her knee last weekend in Waterford, and the girls did the business for her, and I'm sure she's going to love getting that medal today.
Yeah, most definitely. She, as you said, got a bad injury down there against DCU in Waterford last weekend, and as smiling from ear to ear here as it is announced the winners of the Women's Super League playoff 2017, Courtyard Liffey Celtics, and what a season it has been for them. What a year. They dared to dream. They've lost to Glanmire twice this year, once in the league in the regular season, second time in that Hula Hoops National Cup final at the National Basketball Arena in January, and then they went on to beat them in the league in February. And now we are here once more. Liffey Celtics have done enough. They've done enough by 10 points indeed to take the title this year.
Yeah, and it's a 10-point win. That's a very impressive win. and something that they held right through the game when Glanmire tried to push back and they put pressure on and tried to bring the game back. They just kept hitting them back, and they held it at that 9 or 10 points for the whole game, which is, it's very admirable. They really did a super job. Congratulations to the coach.
Mark Byrne there, just heading to collect his medal, his winner's medal, as too is Annette O'Toole, who's worked so tirelessly with this club in Kildare. And now we are going to be announcing the MVP, Sorka Tiernan of Courtyard Liffey Celtics. She's definitely deserved that one, Mike.
Yeah, absolutely. She's impressed me greatly today. She was very confident on the ball. She controlled the offense for them, and when she was left open, she took that two and three on numerous occasions. She did a really, really good job for them. I have to say it was a great team effort from them all, but Sorka did stand out. She had a super job. She did a great game today. Here's the captain, Alva O'Connor, receiving the trophy.
And just waiting for the photos to be taken before she brings it back to the crowd, or to her team rather. So I'm sure the crowd will be joining in those celebrations. And there you have it, folks. This year's Women's Super League playoff champions, Courtyard Liffey Celtics.